students, welcome to Plus One Computer class. So in the previous video, we discussed about different kinds of input and output devices. So the hardware section is over. Advanced input devices, normally used input-output devices that we discussed in the previous video. Then in this video, we are going to discuss another section. Another section means our next section was e-waste, then electronic waste and electronic. Why should we concern about e-waste and after that e-waste disposal methods? So these three sections we are going to discuss now. So we will start with e-waste. So you know, we are discussing about components of computer system. Components of computer system, we discussed about all the hardware parts. Hardware parts means input device, output device, registers, then motherboard, port, serial ports. Okay, all these we discussed. That means hardware means these are the physical parts that we can touch and feel the presence. That kinds of physical units are known as hardwares. Hardwares and software together make a computer system. And that is the definition of computer system. Hardware and software together make a computer system. Then, nowadays we are using different types of electronic equipment, especially mobile phones and computers, laptops, so many electronic devices that we are using. Then, here, actually hardware is consisting of different types of, that means toxic material. So we know a PCB, learned about PCB, printed circuit board. It consists of so many integrated parts or integrated devices. Okay, so that means it forms after their lifetime or after their useful time, it is termed as e-waste. Okay, after their lifetime, useful lifetime, it will be termed as e-waste, electronic waste. Nowadays in our country, tons of e-waste is providing, because nowadays our lifestyle is according to that. We will not reuse the one item again and again. When it is damaged, definitely we will buy another one, exchange offer. So many companies are providing their own exchange offer. So we can exchange and we can buy a new item. We are not trying to repair them all. Okay, so that's why nowadays in our country, huge amount of e-waste is present. So actually it is a drawback. Then we will discuss what is mean by e-waste. So okay, what is the definition of e-waste? What is e-waste? E-waste refers to electronic product nearing to their end of useful life. Okay, so what is e-waste? E-waste refers to electronic product nearing the end of their useful life. If their useful life is over, it will be treated as e-waste. Okay, any of the electronic devices like fridge, TV, washing machine, computer, mobile phone, all these, after their useful life, it will be termed as e-waste. Then, the used electronic which are destined to use them. If one of the electronic device is not working, then we can try, if we can reuse it, we can repair it. If it is repairable, then definitely we can repair it and we can reuse it. Okay, so types of hardware, that means that kinds of electronic equipment nearing to their useful life, that means near to the end of their useful life, is termed as e-waste. Okay, so nowadays huge tons of e-waste is available. Then next one, there is one more statement is present. Why should we concern about e-waste? Why should we concern about e-waste? Why should we concern about e-waste? Why these e-waste is toxic to in nature, or this is harmful for the human life? Okay, why should we concern about e-waste? Okay, you know, for making PCB, printed circuit board, toxic material like lead is used in computer PCB, and also CRT monitor backside, some poisonous material, toxic material is plated up behind the CRT monitor backside. So these kinds of, that means now we are discussing only about computer hardware parts. Then other electronic equipments we are not discussing, but why should we concern about electronic e-waste, especially computer? Then with the help of a table I will explain. In that table, the computer part and the toxic material present in the computer part, and then the causes, that means how it is affecting the human life, that also will be present. So please look at the table. Then in that table, actually there are three columns. First column is chemical, second column is source, and third one is consequence. That means which kind of chemical is present, in which source it is present, then what are the consequences. Then first one, lead. It is very toxic material. It is found as solder on printer circuit board. I already mentioned PCB is very harmful when it is in e-waste. Then and in computer monitor glass, lead can cause, what are the consequences? Lead can cause damage to the central and peripheral nervous system, blood system and kidneys in humans. Clear? So what is the consequences? Which chemical it is? Lead. Then second one is mercury. Found in printer circuit. So look, lead and mercury both present in PCB, computer printer circuit board, LCD screen, backlight. Affect a baby's growing brain and nervous system. Adults can suffer organ damage, mental impairment and a variety of other symptoms. Then third one is cadmium. Source found in chip resistors and semiconductors, cause various types of cancer. Cadmium can also accumulate in the kidney and harm it. Okay, so what are the consequences of cadmium? Then it causes different types of cancer. It also present in semiconductor memory, also present semiconductor or flash memory that we studied in secondary storage devices. Then BFRS, very very toxic material, brominated flame retardant. What is the full form of BFRS? Brominated flame retardant, found in printer circuit board and some other plastics. These toxins may increase the risk of cancer. Okay, so you know the different toxic material like lead, cadmium, mercury, brominated flame retardant, all these. Then you know in all these parts or on all these sources, PCB is common, printer circuit board is common. So nowadays without PCB we can't buy a computer system. When it is in use, nothing will happen, but if it is not in use, that means if it is e-waste and we are dumping all these products into a particular place, then definitely it will affect human life. Okay, so nowadays huge amount of e-waste is present, so you want to make care of e-waste to protect human life. Okay, then if e-waste is present, then definitely e-waste disposal methods also present. E-waste disposal methods. E-waste disposal method means if e-waste is present, if we use them in a proper manner, then it will not affect the human life. Okay, if we treat e-waste in a normal or in a particular manner, then it will not affect. Then there are four methods of e-waste disposal is present. First one is reuse. Okay, if a product or if an electronic machine is not working, please try to reuse it. We can check whether it is repaired. We can repair it. Otherwise, first once you want to check whether we can repair it or not. If we can repair, then we can reuse it again. Okay, that is the first one. It is refers to the second hand use or usage after the equipment has been upgraded or modified. Most of the old computers are passed on to relative, friends or returned to retailer for exchange or for money. I mean, if a computer is not working, then we can sell it and we can buy a new one. Otherwise, we can give it to the relatives, or please try to reuse it. Okay, then the next one, you know, printers. In printers, toner is present. Toner, actually toner is working. In ink also inserted inside the toner. So if your printer is not working, please check whether toner is working or not. Then we can refill the ink cartridge and again we can work on it. So that is reuse. And second one is recycled. Recycle means we can recycle this product, these some of the hardware product, and we can make a new hardware using recycle. So please try to recycle it. Then next one is incineration. Actually, it is a good method for e-waste, but it is very costly and also environmental pollution issues also will come in terms of incineration. Incineration means we are heating or we are burning all these computer hardware at a high temperature. High temperature means 900 to 1000 degrees Celsius. We are burning all the computer hardware at a high temperature from 900 to 1000. So when we are burning these kinds of hardware with high temperature, then definitely it will affect environment or it will make environmental pollution. So for these kinds of methods, that means for incineration, we need a better plan and better mechanism to implement this. Okay, then last method, landfilling. This is not an efficient method for e-waste disposal than landfilling or dumping all the unwanted things into a particular area. Dumping all this into an unwanted area, waste, that kind of thing is known as landfilling. So that is the next e-waste disposal method. We are dumping all the unnecessary hardware part into a particular location. So that is landfilling. Okay, so these are the four e-waste disposal method. For example, in your question paper, you suggest a suitable e-waste disposal method. Which one you will suggest? Always suggest reuse, recycle and also incineration. Reuse and incineration also definitely we can suggest. Or no need to suggest landfilling. Because if we are filling this kind of item into a particular place, then due to rain or some other things, that means by day it will provide, or this toxic materials will mix in water. Okay, and rainwater also, in case of rain, definitely it will mix in rainwater, then it will cause damages to human life and also some other features also. Clear? So these are the four e-waste disposal method. First method is reuse. Please try to reuse it. Then after that recycle. Then incineration. Incineration means we are burning the hardware at high temperature, 900 to 1000 degrees Celsius. Then after that landfilling. Clear? So I think the concept is clear. So these are the e-waste disposal methods. Then next one, actually it is a guidelines to the students. What are the student roles in e-waste management or e-waste disposal? That is the next topic. Student's role in e-waste disposal. Some of the suggestions are already given in your textbook that you want to fulfill or that you want to follow, then you can avoid e-waste. That means we can reduce the amount of e-waste. Then first one is stop buying unnecessary equipment. Okay, stop buying unnecessary equipment. So you know, for smart class, all of them is having mobile phone. Some of them is not having, they are using their parents' mobile. It's very good, because if you are using your parents' mobile, then definitely there will be some amount of security. If you are dealing with your own mobile phone, then there will be chance for other some activities also. If you are your parents' mother's or father's mobile phone, that is good. Okay, then when electronic equipments get faulty, try to repair it instead of buying a new one. If any of the device is not working, if your mobile also is not working, please try to repair it. If it is repairable, then we can reuse it. No need to buy a new one. Then try to recycle electronic equipments by selling them or donating them to others. For example, if you want to buy a new computer, then your old computer you can give to your relatives or to other, any other. That means those who don't have this kind of equipment, you can give it to them. That is the next. Try to recycle electronic equipments by selling them or donating them to others, extending their useful life and keeping them out of the waste stream. Then, if you really need to buy new electronics, then, you know, when you are going to buy electronic, always you check star. Star, what is that? Star indicate in a fridge and also washing machine. 5-star is there. What is that? That means energy conservative system. It uses, that means if you are buying a new product, always check whether the parts of the system available in India or nearby places or not. Then only we can repair it. Okay, that is the next one. If you really need to buy new electronic, choose items which less hazardous substance, greater recycled content, higher energy efficient, longer lifespan, and those that will produce less waste. Then visit the manufacturer's website or call the dealer to find if they have a take back program or scheme. That means exchange offer is there or present. If the device is battery, always buy rechargeable battery. Nowadays all the mobile phone has rechargeable battery. Then buy product with good warranty and their take out policies. So when we are buying electronic equipment, you want to take care of all these guidelines. Then definitely we can avoid some amount of e-waste production. Okay, so this is e-waste. So what we studied in this video, what is meant by e-waste? Then why should we concern about e-waste? Which are the toxic materials and also the substances present? Then what are the consequences of these kind of toxic materials in human life? Then after that we discussed about different types of e-waste disposal methods. What are the different e-waste disposal method? Reuse, recycle. Then incineration and landfilling. And after that, students' role in e-waste mechanism. Okay, so hope you understood. Then you want to write one question in your notebook. That is, you want to write list and explain the various e-waste disposal methods in your notebook. Okay, so hope you understood. The remaining section we will discuss in the next video. Then I am going to attach one video that contains e-waste and also the consequences of e-waste. So please watch the video. By watching this video, we are concluding.
Here are the things that have become an integral part of your life, without which you can't imagine surviving even a day. Your television, something which makes you smile and cry. Your mobile, your most cherished companion day and night. And your charger, without which your mobile is as good as dead. But as soon as they get outdated, they are no more your companions. So what do you do with them? You unsympathetically remove them from your life. Till now, what kept you entertained is today plaguing the world with global warming. Till now, what used to be the pride of your household has today become a source of pollution and illness for someone else. So when our electronic equipment become useless to us, they become e-waste for the environment. The kind of waste that is very different from ordinary waste, as it contains toxic pollutants like mercury, lead, cadmium, chromium and plastics, which are very harmful for human as well as environment. Today there are lakhs of people working in unorganized sector of e-waste disposal. People working in this unorganized sector are often exposed to toxic chemicals during the processing of this waste. Interestingly, this e-waste also consists of valuable substances like gold, silver, and copper. Today, on one hand, we are growing as biggest consumer country of electronics, and at the same time, we are generating vast amount of e-waste.
कभी कभार इन दिनों हमारे यहाँ पहले अच्छी पेन रखना वो स्टेटस था, अच्छी घड़ी रखना स्टेटस था, अब अच्छा फोन रखना स्टेटस हो गया है. e-waste, इसके विषय में अवेयरनेस नहीं है. देखिए, हमारे देश में एनवायरनमेंट की समस्याएं इसलिए आई कि जिसको जीत ठीक लगा कारखाना लगा दिया. दे वर नॉट कॉन्शियस अबाउट इट. हमने ई वेस्ट के संबंध में एक मिशन उठाना चाहिए, ऑनलाइन चलाना चाहिए, अवेयरनेस कैंपेन करना चाहिए, ई वेस्ट के सॉल्यूशन खोजने चाहिए. सरकार के साथ मिलकर के कोई प्रोजेक्ट बनाया जा सकता है ई वेस्ट के सॉल्यूशन, वरना हम पता नहीं कहां से कहां पहुंचे.
Reason why our Honorable Prime Minister took an important step towards creating a clean India. So come, let's together take an oath that we shall not dispose e-waste irresponsibly. We will work towards its scientific disposal so that same e-waste can be reduced, reused and recycled. And to help us realize this dream, we have 150 e-waste authorized recycler functional in India. The details of the same are available at your nearest Common Service Centers, CSC. So now all you have to do is just collect your e-waste and bring it to your nearest e-waste collection center. They will deliver them to their right destination, where wealth will be generated from this waste without causing harm to humans or nature. Given the proper awareness, it will also create employment for thousands of people and will create a clean and healthy India. Clean.